Hi everyone, welcome to the fourth video of Python learning series for network engineers. In this video, we'll see how to install Python package index pip. First, we'll go to my console and I'll show you. In the previous video, we have seen a comparison between Python version 2 and 3, and we checked the Python versions installed in my machine. To check that, Python tab, if you type tab, we'll be able to see multiple versions in my machine: 2.7, 3.4, 3.5, and 3.6. So all these will have different sets of packages installed. To check the package installed in my Python 2.7, I'll go to Python, and here we can type help modules. Is fetching all the libraries installed in my 2.7 version. So you can see there's a lot of packages installed. This is my base machine, so I have installed a lot of packages here. One thing which we will look into is now Paramico. This is one of the third-party package which uses for SSH connection. We can initiate SSH from Python using Paramico. Another command is, I'll come out of this, pip list. We can type, even here also we'll be able to see the available packages, installed packages. You can see you can see the Paramico and its versions. Now we will see Python community's document about pip. So we'll go to python.org, here documentation, docs, python 3.x doc. Here, installing Python modules. Here you'll be able to see pip is the preferred installer program. Starting with 3.4, it is included by default. That means I have 3.6 and there it'll be default. Still, I'll show you how to install that in Python. The command to install pip is sudo apt get install python-pip. So you can see it is already the newest version, so we don't have to install it. I'll give no. And to install any package using pip, the command is pip install Paramico. So what it is saying, I have already installed it in my 2.7, so it is not installing again. So these are some of the dependencies for even Paramico, and here you can see the error for Python 2.7. So 2.7 will reach end of life by January 1st 2020. Another way to check the libraries installed in Python 2.7 is, we'll go to Python. So by default it is going to my 2.7.6. So here we can type help then under help we can type modules. And here also you can see this was one of the default library. I showed it in previous video. Then we'll check for Paramico. This also I have already installed in 2.7. Now we'll install it in 3.6 manually. So that we'll be able to initiate SSH from our Python scripts. So I'll press Ctrl D to come out of that. Now we'll go to Python 3.6. Here also help modules. Sorry, help parenthesis modules. We'll check the Paramico module here. So you can see I don't have any Paramico module. So what I'll do, I'll install Paramico here. So I'll come out of the commanders. Pip 3 install Paramico. Yeah, now it is installed Paramico. So earlier I have tried once, that's why some of the dependencies it already met, but it has installed Paramico now. Now we'll go and check the Paramico library in 3.6, Python 3.6. Yeah, help. Modules. Yeah, you can see now Paramico is available here. Now to check the details of Paramico library, I'll go to Python 3.6, help, then we'll list out the modules. I'll type Paramico here. Yeah, you can see the details of Paramico and its supported classes here. And to see how to use Paramico, this is one of my script which uses initiating SSH to a router. So here I import Paramico, and then here you can see db is equal to paramico.ssh client, and it initiates the connection. Here I can give the IP address I have mentioned as variable here, and so it fetches from here. Then I'll be using Paramico for the communication with the device. So in this way you'll be able to use, and even from Python interpreter you will be able to see the Paramico details. I'll show how. If I press enter, it'll come out of help, and here I'll type help Paramico. It'll be showing it is not defined, so I need to import Paramico here. I'll be explaining it detail. So here I just need to show how to use the external libraries. Now I'll type again help. Now it will show the same document. To come out of that, press Ctrl D. I will go to now Paramico's official site. Yeah, this is a Paramico official site. Here you can see some of the dependencies what they are saying. So Paramico has a few direct dependencies. So one is cryptography. We'll see whether that is installed in my Python 3.6 by default. I'll go to Python 3.6. Now I'll type help modules. I will check the cryptography dependency here. Yeah, you can see here it is already there. And even other dependencies also, it is met in my machine. So if you're interested, you can even go through this site and get more information. Now we'll see if we try to reinstall it again. We'll type pip 3. Install Paramico. Yeah, so it says it is already satisfied all the requirements. Even Paramico also I have installed, so it is not installing again. And another message what I'm getting is the version which I use in my Python 3.6, the Paramico version is 9.0.1 and the latest one is 19.0.3, so they are giving the command to upgrade it. So before we upgrade it, we'll see how to check the version. The command is pip -- version. You can see in 2.7 I have 19.0.3 and pip 3 -- version. You can see I have 9.0.1, so I have multiple versions of Python, and inside that I have different versions of pip installed. So we'll try upgrading it. Yeah, now here you can see it has installed the pip version 19 here. We'll verify that pip 3 -version. Yeah, now it is 19.3. the command is pip 3 install - upgrade pip. Now you have seen multiple versions of Python in my machine and multiple versions of libraries, different libraries, and all these things can create a version conflict in our base machine. So if you want to use a particular version for a different script, you won't be able to do until you touch and edit your base machine's packages. To avoid all these issues, you can use virtual environment. In the next video, I'll be showing how to install and use virtual environment. Virtual environment will create isolated environment for individual Python projects, so that without touching base machines, packages and libraries, you will be able to create individual virtual environments and install the packages there. I hope this video was helpful for you to understand how to install pip, how to upgrade pip, and how to install the third-party packages. See you in the next video where I'll show virtual environment. Thanks for watching.